Assalamu alaikum. So this is Fun with Ruha and we are going to read the storybook The Whistling Donkey by Cheryl Rao. So here is the title page of this book. When Dinky and Pinky were born, Mama and Papa were the happiest donkeys in town. They looked at their two donkey babies and they raised their heads and sang loudly. Yes, these were singers. They sang at weddings, they sang at parties. So, these donkeys were singers and they liked to sing. Here is the family picture. This is Daddy Donkey and this is Mama Donkey. This is Dinky and this is Pinky. They sang for animals. They sang for people. They sang all the time. They sang even if no one wanted them to. So, they like to sing. Look at the other animals. They are watching them singing. Here are some people who also watching them singing. Dinky twin sister Pinky had a wonderful voice. When Pinky sang, everyone stopped to listen. But Dinky didn't like to sing. All he liked to do was suck his hoof. Look at the picture here. Dinky is still sucking his hoof. If it was not the front hoof, it was the back hoof. And if it was not the left hoof, it was the right hoof. One hoof was always in his mouth. Take your hoof out of your mouth and sing, said Mama. Dinky opened his mouth. He left his voice come through. Hur, whoosh, whoosh, he went. That's only noise, said Papa. It's not even donkey noise. So, Papa was furious on Dinky. Here, Mama is teaching them how to sing. Then Mama pointed to Dinky's open mouth. Look at his teeth, she cried. Oh no, Dinky had made his teeth crooked by sucking his hooves all the time. One front tooth stuck out, another front tooth went in. The rest of his teeth were here and there. Look at the teeth. The teeth are here and there. Mama is pointing. Mama and Papa didn't know what to do. The whole family had to sing at a concert in a barn that weekend. Everyone was coming to listen to the singing donkeys. What would they say when they saw Dinky's crooked teeth? What would they say if they knew he would not sing? So Mama and Papa were worried about Dinky's tooth and they were thinking about what would others say about Dinky's teeth. Papa said, open and close your mouth along with us at the concert. Mama said, but don't open your mouth too wide. So this is the concert day and all the animals are coming to the barn because the concert was held at the barn. Dinky nodded obediently. On the day of concert, the four of them went on stage. Look at the picture. The donkeys are on the stage and the other animals are here. Then all of them opened their mouths, Dinky just a little, and three of them swayed and sang. Hee hee ee ha 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 ha. The crowd loved it. They clapped and stamped and jumped. So the donkeys were singing their song, and the animals were enjoying the song. They were clapping, stamping, and jumping. They clapped and stamped and jumped so much that the barn began to shake. Dinky was not moving, so he left the barn shaking. He tried to tell his parents to do something, but they were still singing because all the animals were enjoying the concert, so no one notices that the barn is shaking. So Dinky took a deep breath. He blew up his chest and he opened his mouth wide, showing all his crooked teeth and all the gaps in his teeth. And he gave a great loud whistle, just like a policeman's whistle. Everyone heard it. Everyone fell silent. Then they cried, "Run, police! Run, police!" Mama, Papa, and Pinky stopped swaying and singing, and then they felt the barn shaking. They too ran out just as the barn came crashing down. Look at the barn. All the animals are running. Dinky had saved them. Dinky was so happy that he rolled Run round and round on the grass until he came to a field where the animals were playing a football match. Look, the animals are playing the football match, and Dinky is rolling on the ground. Suddenly, the football landed on him. Dinky didn't get up. He just pounded the ball in the air with one hoof, then kicked it into the goal at the far end of the field with another hoof. Look at the ball. Mama and Papa and Pinky and all the football players were amazed. Someone kicked the ball to him again, and because he was so used to twisting his legs here and there to get a hoof into his mouth, he kicked it back smartly. "You are a born footballer," said the captain of the football team and threw a blue jersey to Dinky. "Join us." Here is the football team captain, and he threw the jersey towards Dinky. Dinky shrugged. "I will try it," he thought. "It can't be as difficult as singing." Now Dinky is the star of the blue team. His legs go his way and that, and it is difficult to get the ball away from him because he was used to move his hooves. At sometimes, when he is tired of running and winning matches for his team, he gives a good imitation of the referee's whistle and calls for a break. So this was the end of the storybook. I hope you liked the video. Please like and subscribe for more such video. Thank you.